Hello, I'm here in Paris covering the Olympic Games. I'm here at an open square right in front of the MPC, the main press center. And this is a typical Parisian neighborhood. I can see the Bronx pizzeria in front of me. There's a McDonald's. There's lots of patisseries and bars. So a very typical Parisian neighborhood. But this summer in Paris is not typical, and that's because of the heightened security around the Olympic Games. This morning we had set out in a taxi to do an interview, but we never managed to get there. We didn't manage to get there in time because all routes have been diverted. Yesterday, around the Eiffel Tower near a restaurant, there was a car detected, an empty car that was detected, and it was possibly a bomb threat. Our colleagues Rohan and Trisha were there, and they have already reported from there. You know, it was possibly a bomb threat, and the entire area was cordoned off. People were not allowed to leave for an hour. Rohan and Trisha were stuck there for an hour, and they spoke to locals. And for myself, I have been to Paris several times in the past, and Paris stands for, you know, a kind of laid-back relaxation, people sitting in their in the cafes, enjoying their coffees and, you know, talking away. Paris stands for that kind of ethos. But this time in Paris, it is different. It is full of security. All cars are being checked. Even journalists like us who are wearing our accreds, we have been asked to carry our passports, some kind of state-issued identification, or we will not be allowed to enter the venues or even, you know, in front of the MPC, the main press center. There is a whole lot of checking. The police are everywhere. We have seen loads of police on bikes. They are patrolling everywhere. So this is a very different Paris from the Paris that we know, and it's all about the possible security threats and the heightened security around the Olympic Games, and especially the opening ceremony, which will be unprecedented because it will be an open-air ceremony. The athletes from different countries will come sailing in boats on the Seine. So that definitely calls for enhanced security. But this is a very different Paris that we are seeing. And we will get more updates to you on Rev Sports. This is a breaking update on Paris from Rev Sports. Keep tuned.